types of videos. Sometimes somebody reminded me of them. So I just said here on Twitter, going to attempt a guessing phrases in other languages video again. Hit me up with some non-English phrases. Because let's face it, if they're in English phrases, then it's not guessing phrases in other languages. It's guessing phrases in my language. And that's not that hard, because it's not a guess, it's just called reading. And then we get called this a let's read. And then Audible would sue me. So let's see what people come up with. Oh, sweet mother of God. Translate from Dutch. Okay, oh God, I have no idea how Dutch sounds. So, here we go. Heb je ooit even naar jezelf? Jezelf, I'm going to call myself that. In de spiegel gekeken. This is German. Als ik ju was zo ik dat 24/7. I got that part. Don't want je bent zo mooi. Oh. Okay, okay, I can get this. Spiegel, sounds like spiel. Sprachen? No. Do you see yourself speaking gecko? Also, if you were awake 24/7, what would you do? I feel confident about that. Have you ever looked at yourself in the mirror? If I were you, I'd do that 24/7 because you are so beautiful. No, trying to win me over with compliments. It's working. But also, I got that horribly wrong. Oh, no. See, this is where I ran into huge trouble because I can't read Chinese alphabet characters, so I couldn't even attempt to figure out what that says at all, even in that language. So I'm just gonna say hello. I love you. I need to be more specific with these things. Why would anyone just say hello? Actually, why would anyone just say I love you? But thank you, canned bread. Je suis du pain. Okay, it looks like je suis du pain, but that's French, and I think that means I am bread. No utilise Google Translate para esto. Don't use Google Translate for this. I did not use Google Translate for this. Fuck! Damn it! You're caught red-handed! You're not good at Spanish! You just used the Google Translate! Can't do that! Even though that's basically what I do. Well, I'm using Bing Translate. I'm a higher form of Bing. I'm a higher form of Bing. Okay, this is Swedish. I kind of know how some Swedish words are pronounced by now. Robin, I never hear the Swedish person out there. I'm sorry. Det och helt otroligt voder ut. I kind of know how to pronounce, like, voder. Kind of, I don't know. Oh, that could be all right. Okay, I have to figure out what it actually means. That is held in high regard. No. Do you play the ute? Wait, ute is not a thing. What does it mean? It's unbelievable weather out. But sure is. That's what I said. So I meant all along. Did you hear me say that? I hold you in high regard. What do I go for? It said held. So it sounded like held, which I said hold. I don't know why I do that. Okay, so this is Japanese, and I don't know how to pronounce Japanese either. I don't even know how to read Japanese characters. If it was Korean, I'd be able to read it. But they said below, pronounced as anata wa sugoi desu. Okay. Sorry, I forgot you can't read the symbols. No, I'm sorry that I can't read the symbols. Anata wa sugoi desu. Sugoi means like awesome. Or something like that. Like really good. You are awesome. You're amazing! Same diff! It all means that kind of like really good feeling. It's like, I can't even think of a word that translates the same. Anyway, I know what sugoi means! Oh, sugo! We've been watching a lot of Boku no Hero Academia. I know some Japanese now. I am weeaboo. what's it? Oh, hontoni kakuine! Is that something like you were really cool or something? Okay, you tried. You said annyeonghaseyo. It's annyeonghaseyo. Sarange senpai. Senpai is Japanese though. But you said hello, I love you, senpai. Basically, thank you. Appreciate it. I'm just smelling smoke. I'm not saying that as like a joke to this, it sounds like, I'm smelling all the smoke, you're blowing up my ass. No, the window's open, I can actually smell a chimney smoke. It is actually quite cold here, so neighbors, don't burn your house down. Mi amigo, dígame, por favor, ¿dónde está mi niña rata? Mm-hmm. That means, my friend! My friend! What's with all this standing around? Please, where is something? Where is my niña? Does that mean like little girl or something? Please tell me, where has my little girl gone? My friend, please tell me, where is my rat girl? Ah, I was almost right! Oh, I knew it was my girl. Rat, where's my rat girl? I don't know! Okay! Somebody said I wanted to do it's lit fam in French, but c'est la famille éclairée, which means it is the enlightened family. I should say that from now on. Instead of being like, it's lit fam, just be like, it is the enlightened family. Oh, I love this. Somebody's using Japanglish. English, Japanese. This is the way I used to do Korean, was Konglish. It would be Korean, but in romanized characters. So this is nani, which means what in Japanese. See, I'm watching a lot of anime. I know what they're saying. Because I was like, nani? Which I saw somebody on Reddit recently. There was something, some Japanese meme went around, and somebody said, nani the fuck? Around the house, me and Sina say it all the time now. It's fun. Je sens comme du bœuf de la lustre. I knew it was French anyway. They say come lust for the beef. I know that's not what it means. I'm just saying funny stuff, so I don't know what it says. I smell like beef about the chandelier. I had that on Instagram one time. I smell like beef from the chandelier. Nice one. Wait, lustre is fucking chandelier? I thought chandelier, or chandelier. I thought the chandelier was a French word already. Okay. Du bist meinen Held und vor meinen Freunden. Ich liebe dich, Jack. Okay, that means I love you, Jack. Thank you. Du bist meinen Held und vor meinen Freunden. So something, my something and my friend, for my friend. Could you say hi to me and my friend? I love you, Jack. You're my hero for my friends. I love you, Jack. Oh, that's so sweet. Oh, you guys. Come on, where's the jokes? Where's the insults? Where's the dicks? Give me shit. Stop being so nice to me all the time. I appreciate them. Come on, man. We can joke around. We can get a little fucked up here. Hey. That means hi, or hey, in French. Vous sentiez belle. Passez une bonne journée, mon bois. Or mon boy. Mon boy! Oh, please tell me French people you go around saying stuff like that. Mon boy! shit, I would have known what this meant back in secondary school, back when I was like 17. 17, when I was like very heavily deep into French in school then. Restaurateur Bell. I've heard that before. Passez une bonne journée, mon bois. Oh, fuck. You are good. Along my special journey, my boy. Hey, feel beautiful. Have a good day, my boy. It was boy. It wasn't bois. I was making memes sound like French. French people, you don't know what it's like, okay? Comment ça va? Ah, ça va bien, et toi? I don't know why I said it like, ah, ça va bien, ah, et toi? It's not fucking French at all, but yeah, I'm good. How are you? G'day, mate. Want to chuck a couple of shrimps in the barbie? I'll be fair dinkum. Shrews, mate. Fuck you know. I said I kind of like an Englishman then after that. That's Australian, and it means, hello there, fellow compatriot. Would you like to go cook a couple of shrimps on my barbecue, friend? It will be the great time. I speak Australian pretty well. Yeah, I look, there's some nut cut. I love some nut balls. I smell like pizza. I wanna know what it's pronounced like. Robin, I need your help. Yeah, look, that nut shot. Yeah, look, that nut shot. I smell like beef. Well, that was horribly wrong. Oh, this is cool. Somebody said this is sign language. This hasn't happened in a video like this before. That's awesome. Oh, God, I have no idea what that means. Oh, there was a lot in that. I didn't expect it to go on as long as it did. That's fucking awesome. The problem with this is that I can't translate this. Like some of the others, I picked the ones that I can actually physically translate so I can see if I'm actually partially correct at all. With something like this, I can't. I literally would not even know where to start. Okay, I'm gonna make up something. I'm not trying to offend or anything like that. I think this is the coolest thing ever. So let's do this. Hello, my name is The Boss. I'm heavy metal as fuck, and I would really like it if I could get tickets to the Under Over Show Metal. Oh, I have no idea. Oh, they probably said something really nice now, and I have fucking no clue. Sam, if you're watching this, I'm sorry, please let me know what you said. I'm fascinated. Here, I said I just tried this in the video and have no idea what it means. Could you elaborate so I know how wrong I was? Hopefully they reply so then we'll actually know. They said it means, hi Jack, I love you and thank you for being a wonderful human. Oh, thank you, Sam. I'm glad you replied as well. I'm glad we cleared that up so I didn't just butcher it and then leave it there. Thank you. Aw, that's so sweet. Okay, well that's it for this video on trying to guess phrases in other languages. Who knew? I was horrible at it, as I always have been. But these are super fun to do. It's always really nice to see the diversity of people who watch the videos. And not just different spoken languages, but this time we even had sign language in the video. That's awesome. I love seeing stuff like that. I love seeing the different people and the different like ethnicities and the different nationalities of people who watch the content. There's a huge abundance of, I keep seeing German, French, Dutch, Spanish, and Japanese. Those seem to be very strong 5 recurring languages in the videos, which I guess makes sense because a lot of the audience speak English. So I don't know, it's always just fascinating to me. It's so weird to think that you can upload videos on the internet where I'm speaking English all the time, but it manages to transcend and go worldwide, and so many different people from so many different language barriers and language fronts can understand it and get in on it. And even if they don't understand it fully, they still watch it. Some people out there might not speak English very well, they might not even hear English very well, but there's a lot of people out there who still love the videos, which always surprises me. So just thank you guys from all walks of life for watching what I do and being part of all of this together. It not only makes it cooler, but it also opens up my mind and broadens my thoughts on the amount of different walks of life from people who are here. So, and it teaches me a lot as well, and it makes me more understanding of different cultures, I think, whenever something actually happens, to know that there's so many different types of people out there watching the content that, I don't know, I'm not as narrow-minded as I used to be before I started YouTube. And it's stuff like this that kind of really opens up my mind to the possibilities for how far-reaching all of this is. It's cool, but thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you liked it, punch that like button in the face! Thank you, boys! And high fives all around!